question to the Treasurer. Is the Treasurer aware of concerns in the community arising from proposals that have been put forward to inflation adjust the tax system? Can he explain to the House the effect such a proposal would have if it were ever implemented, particularly on business and those on modest incomes?
The Honourable the Treasurer.
Speaker, there has been considerable disquiet in the community over a proposal to inflation adjust the tax system, and much of the concern arises from the confusion over whether such a proposal would be a partial adjustment or a comprehensive adjustment. Either way, the concern is well founded. At this stage, the proposal is to inflation adjust the taxation of interest, but not stocks or depreciation, a lopsided, terrible mix-up of the tax system. But the plan is for partial adjustment because comprehensive adjustment would cost billions. Indeed, the Treasury has estimated the costs would range from $3.5 billion to $4 billion in a full year. The choice, leaving a gaping hole in the budget, is to leave a gaping hole in the budget or raise tax rates. As an example of how this would affect small business, Mr. Speaker, the tax bill of the average farmer would rise by up to $40 a week, a typical cab owner driver by $50 a week, an interstate truck driver by $75 a week, a typical service station owner, tax would rise by 75%, and it would double for a motel owner, that is, as the proportion, as the requirements of their business require them to take on gearing and the effects of this measure on the costs of that gearing. It would similarly have a similar impact in terms of a massive shock to large business, and would also throw Australia in with a hyperinflation country such as Brazil. But apart from the attack on business, the plan would hit those at the lower end of the income scale. The tax office figures show that taxpayers on $100,000 or more would benefit by $90 a week, yet taxpayers in the $20,000 to $30,000 range would benefit by $4 a week, which is, of course, a classic piece of Liberal Party tax policy, as somebody interjects. In fact, Mr. Speaker, since this proposal was floated by the Leader of the Opposition during the mock election campaign, he held some weeks ago and is now trying to forget, concern has mounted. Only yesterday, Senator Stone was backing away from the proposal, saying that, he said, which I emphasise has always been just that, a proposal. So this great centrepiece of coalition policy is now just that, a proposal. And that's, of course, he also goes on to say that the plan will be ready in 10 days' time, when he says that Access Economics will get the report, will get the report on that in the very near future, in fact, in the next 10 days or so. So that information will be in. Yet Access Economics themselves said, Mr. Carmody said, if we go down that route, this is inflation adjustment, it should be done on a comprehensive basis, otherwise you're basically moving away from a level playing field. So the person which is actually costing this proposal, or the person associated with the organisation which is costing this proposal, has actually said, if you go for partial inflation adjustment, you're moving away from a level playing field. So the person costing it, the so-called technician costing it, has damned it already, saying you would be moving away from a level playing field. But interestingly, in today's Australian, we now have the President of the Liberal Party panning the plan. And let me quote from The Australian. At a meeting which was held to discuss this and other matters, which the Leader of the Opposition attended, it said one source who attended the Sheraton Hotel dinner said it was made clear to Mr. Peacock that the application of the scheme to debt would involve huge increases to the cost of business borrowings. Well, that's nothing more than the Prime Minister and I said a couple of weeks ago. Mr. Peacock was told the plan would alter the whole structure of corporate financing in the community, and that it was a revolutionary proposal. That's revolutionary, all right. It's revolutionary. The source said it was assumed that as a result of the concerns expressed at the dinner, Mr. Peacock would back off the plan. Well, Mr. Speaker, this begs the question, who is running the Liberal Party? Is it Mr. Elliott, or is it the Leader of the Opposition who's been not impolitely told to back off? It'll be interesting to see, as we see the countdown to Liberal policy, who will win. Will Mr. Peacock stick to his guns, and will he do, or will he do what he's told by Mr. Elliott? And what of the Peacock two-step tax plan? Will the two-step become a tango with Mr Elliott on the tax plan? Does Mr Elliott favour the two or three or four-step tax plan? Well, Mr Speaker, we await with bated breath. We await with bated breath to the great tax announcement by the Coalition, which is only... Oh, here's Bozo interjecting.
Order. The Treasurer will refer to members by their title.
Well, the member for Wentworth, who has not asked a question. You couldn't
order.
Think of one question to ask about the economy in 2 weeks, and you're sitting over there interjecting. Anyway, Mr Speaker, I'll conclude on this point. It's 24 days to count... 20 countdown time, 24 days to go to the big tax plan. And, of course, we know the member for Wentworth is going to go across to New York to a private seminar. The Leader of the Opposition is apparently on some other trip, so there's going to be a lot of cramming done between now and 24 days hence for the appointed day when the Liberals' tax policy will finally be announced.
The Honourable